egg retrieval for IVF is performed by passing a needle through the vagina and directly into the ovaries. If that sounds like it might be painful, you're right, it is painful. And egg retrieval is therefore performed under anesthesia. You probably already knew that, but did you know that there are different types of anesthesia given for an egg retrieval? Some types of anesthesia might not work very well for you. It is extremely important, therefore, for you to find out what type of anesthesia is given at your chosen IVF center before you start the IVF process. First, let's talk about sedation. Sedation is also known as monitored anesthesia care, or MAC for short. Medications are given, usually through an IV, to make you feel drowsy and relaxed. Different levels of sedation are possible depending on the type of procedure. Minimal sedation is what people have sometimes referred to in the past as twilight. With this type of anesthesia, you will feel drowsy and relaxed, but you will still be aware of what's going on around you. Moderate sedation is also known as conscious sedation or procedural sedation. At this level, you are semi-conscious. You can still breathe on your own and respond to painful stimulation. In our opinion, minimal and moderate sedation are not adequate for an egg retrieval for two reasons. First is that you will still feel too much pain during the procedure. Second, because of that pain, you might move around too much, which could increase the risk that the doctor might damage something in your abdomen with the needle. During deep sedation, you are very nearly unconscious and will typically not respond to painful stimuli, even if it is repeated and very painful stimulation. Remember, sometimes sedation is called MAC or monitored anesthesia care. Some people may refer to deep sedation as a Big Mac, like the popular hamburger. Deep sedation is nearly the same as general anesthesia. At times with deep sedation, the patient may need assistance with breathing. During general anesthesia, you are completely unconscious and will always need assistance from the anesthesia provider with breathing. General anesthesia is what most people think of when they hear the word anesthesia. Many different medications may be used during general anesthesia. Some are anesthetic gases or vapors that are given through a breathing tube or a mask. Some medications are given through the IV to induce sleep, relax muscles, and treat pain. The use of deep sedation is preferred for performing egg retrievals. General anesthesia is usually reserved for extraordinary circumstances, such as for people with certain medical problems or who can't tolerate deep sedation. But what medications are used for sedation? I don't want to go into a deep dive on pharmacology here. Suffice it to say that for the deep sedation needed for an egg retrieval, there are usually two or three medications that are given. And it is perfectly appropriate for you to ask your doctor which of these medications might be used during the egg retrieval. Be sure you ask before you start the IVF process. If it is the day before your egg retrieval is scheduled, it might be too late to make any changes. The three medications which are most often used for deep sedation in an egg retrieval are fentanyl, propofol, and sometimes Versed. But what do each of these medications do? Versed is mostly used as a relaxing medication, though it can also provide some sedation. Versed by itself does not block pain sensations. Fentanyl is a morphine derivative. It is the medication used to block the pain signals between your brain and the rest of your body. In other words, fentanyl is the painkiller. It is given through your IV, it works very quickly, but it is also out of your body very quickly. Finally, there is propofol. The first thing you should know about propofol is that unlike fentanyl and Versed, which are clear, propofol is white. It actually looks like milk. Propofol produces deep sedation by acting on your brain. Propofol is what makes deep sedation really possible. Like fentanyl, however, propofol is short-acting, so once they stop giving it to you, you will wake up relatively quickly. Who should be administering your anesthesia? In the USA, nurses are authorized by many state medical boards of nursing to administer mild or moderate sedation. Propofol is meant to cause deep sedation and is not, therefore, typically given by nurses. The exception to this general rule is if there is an anesthesiologist in the area to supervise. Therefore, in order to be sure you will get deep sedation, make sure that your IVF center uses either an anesthesiologist who is a physician or a certified registered nurse anesthetist, or CRNA. Where's a safe place to have anesthesia? A hospital or a licensed ambulatory surgery center, like the Naperville Fertility Center where I do my egg retrievals, is going to be the safest choice. What about in a back room in a doctor's office? In my opinion, this is a hit or miss proposition. There may be some locations that are perfectly fine. I have seen centers who employ an anesthesia service who bring all of the equipment needed along with well-trained anesthesia providers. I have also seen some doctor's office procedure areas that are frankly very scary. Every patient can be different. I have seen patients that had to be converted from deep anesthesia to general anesthesia because the anesthesia provider couldn't safely get the amount of deep sedation necessary to make the patient pain-free, or because they were having some other medical problem related to the sedation. In general, egg retrieval is a very safe procedure, but it is not completely risk-free. Having providers, facilities, and equipment to handle emergencies is always a good idea. Our Infertility TV bottom line is this: in 2023, there is no reason why you can't be made comfortable during an egg retrieval. Be proactive in choosing an IVF center that will do that for you. Infertility TV is your most trusted source for accurate information on infertility and miscarriage. If you are not a subscriber yet, hit the subscribe button right now. A new episode is released every week. Don't miss any episodes. You can also check us out on our website, IVF1.com, where you can become a patient.